Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Chapter some basic principles and concepts of chemistry, and we are doing the topic that is determination of percentage of nitrogen by Jalal Smith. Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have studied the estimation of nitrogen by the Jalal's method, and now we are going to determine it with a help of a numerical. So let us do that. So now we are going to do a problem which is based on determination of percentage of nitrogen by Jalal's method. So the question is in this format, and it has been given as, that is, in estimation of nitrogen by Jalal's method, that is 0.62 gram of the organic compound was heated. So therefore the weight of the organic compound is given as 0.62 gram, and it was been heated with the H2SO4, and when the organic compound is been reacted with the H2SO4, and if that organic compound consists of the nitrogen, then obviously the ammonium sulfate would be formed. So therefore the ammonium sulfate that is formed, that was boiled with excess amount of NaOH, and that has liberated the NH3, and that NH3 was been passed through 50 ml of 0.2 molar H2SO4. So therefore this is the 50 ml of 0.2 molar H2SO4 that has been taken in excess, and in this case after the experiment the H2SO4 was titrated with 0.15 molar NaOH, which required 42 ml of for the titration. That means the NaOH that was been required, it was 42 ml of the NaOH that was been required of the concentration 0.15 molar, so as to do the neutralization process for the 0.2 molar H2SO4 that was been present in the solution, or that was been present in the flask, and in which NH3 was been passed. So now let us understand that what are the given data that are been given in this question. So talking about the first one, that is the weight of the organic compound. So we could write it in this way, that is the mass of organic compound, let me denote it by small m, and that has been given as like 0.62 gram. So this is the data that they have given us. And talking about the next one, that is 50 ml of 0.2 molar H2SO4 solution is present in the flask in which the NH3 has been passed. So now therefore this is the volume of the H2SO4 having a concentration of 0.2 molar. So therefore we could write it as, that is volume, let V1 will be the volume of, or I would write it here as volume of H2SO4 present before reaction. Or that has been present. So that is basically 50 ml. And in this case, the next one is given as, and the concentration is given as 0.2 molar. So therefore, this M1 will be the concentration of the H2SO4, that is nothing but 0.2 molar. And talking about the next one, that is the H2SO4 now that has been left out, that has been treated with 0.15 molar of NaOH. So therefore I could write it as the second concentration as or I could write it as M2 as 0.15 molar, while the 42 ml will be the V2. So therefore I could write it over here as, that is V2 is given as, that is 42 ml, and that of the concentration or the molarity of the NaOH that has been given as, that is 0.15 molar. So this is the data that has been provided to us, and from which regarding this is all that has been provided to us, and now it would be very much easy for us to calculate what would be the percentage of the nitrogen. But before understanding what would be the percentage of the nitrogen, it is very essential for us to understand that how much mass of the nitrogen we would obtain. But before understanding that also, that let me understand what is the formula that was for the percentage of the nitrogen for the using Jalal's method. So therefore we could write the formula as, and the formula was very much simple to understand, that is the percentage of nitrogen, it was equals to, that is 14 into 2, that is M1 V1 divided by 1000 minus M2 V2 divided by 2 into 1000 into 100 divided by m. So this is the thing that we have, and let me tell you that what are these terms related to. So this is basically the M1 V1 divided by 1000. This is the number of moles of the hydrogen that was the number of moles of the H2SO4 that was been present initially, and that is we have 50 ml of 0.2 molar H2SO4. So therefore, by calculating this thing, we could get the number of moles of H2SO4 that was present initially. And now this is basically the one that is M2 V2 divided by 2 into 1000 that was been the H2SO4 that was been reacted with the NaOH. So ultimately, we could say that this much amount of the or this much moles of the H2SO4 now has been reacted with the NH3, or that has been consumed by NH3, and for which we have to take the percentage of that also. So therefore, we have multiplied by 100 and divided by the total mass of the organic compound that we had. So now the only thing that we have to do is we have to substitute the values over here, and let us see what is the answer that we could get. So the percentage of the nitrogen can be easily calculated, like 14 into 2 into, instead of M1 we will write the values that was been given to us, and the concentration of H2SO4 that was 0.2 molar, and that of the concentration that of the volume of the H2SO4 that was been initially present, that was 50 ml divided by the 1000 minus the concentration of the NaOH that was been reacted with the H2SO4, and in that case the concentration of NaOH that was basically 0.15, and that of the volume, it was basically 42 ml of the NaOH was been required so as to do the titration with the that is H2SO4, and this is 2 multiplied by 100 because 1 mole of H2SO4 will be reacted with 2 moles of NaOH. Therefore, 2 moles of NaOH will consume actually 1 mole of H2SO4. So therefore, this is the one that was been reacted with the H2SO4 that was been reacted with the NaOH, and this is the final thing that we could get, that is been left out. So therefore, here it is what we are going to insert, that is 100 divided by this small m is nothing but that is mass of the organic compound that we have, and from this only that is the NH3 will be produced, and from this only basically NH3 will be produced, but before that is the organic compound will react with sulfuric acid so as to form ammonium sulfate. So therefore, we could write it over here, that is the small m, that is the mass of the organic compound, is 0.62. So therefore, we are going to substitute over here as 0.62. So after this thing, let us calculate the thing and let us see that what is the percentage that we could get. So after the calculation of this thing that we have did over here, so therefore we could get the answer as 30.93%. So therefore, we could say that in that organic compound that we have got, that is 0.62. So therefore, 0.62 gram of that organic compound will react with the sulfuric acid, and the sulfuric acid has a concentration of 0.2 molar, and we have taken 50 ml of the H2SO4 that has been present in excess, and out of which basically some of the H2SO4 was being reacted with NaOH so as to form a neutralization process, and the remaining part was being reacted with NH3, and from that we could get the percentage of the nitrogen that was been that could be calculated in this manner, and we have substituted the formulas over here, and yes, we have also substituted the values over here, and that it was, we could get the percentage as 30.93%. So this is a method that we could determine what would be the percentage of the nitrogen that has been present in the organic compound by using the Jordahl's method. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video, and you share this video with your friends, and just don't forget to subscribe to Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.